How do I say goodbye to what we had? The good time that made us laugh, I'm waiting back.
Straight up, I just kept thinking they really did shoot.
I thought we could.
I got shot that no black person ever shoot me. I was their representative. I believe that, you know, I didn't have to fear my own community. You know, I was like, I represent it's that. I'm the ambassador to the world. They would never harm me. They would never rob me. They would never hurt me. But as proven by this false race charge, as proven by the gunshot, as proven by a lot of the comments you read in the news and in the media.
I don't know. Is going to
be. I was just more like a kid. You know what I'm saying? He always getting shot or shot at. He gonna pull through this one again, make a few records about it, and it's gonna be over. You know what I'm saying? But when he died, I was just like, whoa. You know what I'm saying? Kind of took me by. I mean, even though we were going through our drama, I would never wish death on nobody. You know what I'm saying? 'Cause ain't no coming back from that. So it kind of turned me down a little bit. But at the same time, you know, you gotta move on. You know, I felt for his mom, for his family or whatever, but, you know, things gotta move on, you know?
Shots, we heard the shot.
The car just rolled up on the side. It was literally by itself. We just start shooting holes on the big door. You know, I jumped out the car to search for myself to see if I was shot. But, you know, I didn't really hit me
there. I had to call his mother. Damn hospital, man. That was crazy.
I picked up the phone and I heard a man crying. And I recognized the man's voice. And right then and there, I knew something was wrong with my son.
It's like they killed him. It's like he is gone. And I wish that I could tell you that it was a lie. He's like, but it's not.
The last Sunday morning, just shortly after midnight, the individual notorious B.I.G. was shot and pronounced dead.
They drove his body through Brooklyn. That's when I realized, my God, my son was famous.
There's a lot of talent, but there are very few people that really take it to another level where you can tell that their records are going to live for 20, 30, and 40 years. And Biggie was one of those artists.